Because YouTube is not, like, the money I make from YouTube is not my primary income source, sometimes I forget how awesome it is to be monetized by YouTube. And I forget to look at analytics that make me even more aware of how awesome it is. And every month I have been sharing with you guys how much money I make from YouTube and my analytics and all of that good jazz. But then I clicked on the 365 tab, like how much money have I made from YouTube in the last year? And oh, I've got to share this. Hey, howdy, hey, welcome back to my channel. I am pumped that you are here. If this is the first time we're meeting, just make sure you say hi in the comments. Make sure you stick around to the end of the video. And if you're already like, I like this girl, then go ahead and hit subscribe because I like you too. All right, so I have shared my YouTube journey a little bit in several videos, but just to kind of summarize my YouTube journey and how long it's taken me to get to where I am now, which is almost 90,000 subscribers at the time I'm recording this. I started my YouTube channel in 2016, but I was only using it as an asset to my blog post. I was basically only using videos to go with my blog post and using YouTube as kind of just a host for those videos. I wasn't optimizing anything. I wasn't like nothing. I wasn't super consistent, none of it. But then in 2017, around mid-year, around June, I realized that I was almost up to 500 subscribers on YouTube. And that was without really doing a lot. And I remember kind of having the thought, like if I could get to 500 subscribers on YouTube without doing too much, then I could probably get to, you know, several thousand, whatever, when I put strategy into it. And so in June of 2017 is kind of when I made the decision to really go full force and really say, okay, YouTube is my platform. I'm gonna be consistent here. I'm gonna do everything I can and I'm gonna get this done. Now, it just so happens that around that same time is when my channel got monetized. Now, I don't remember what the monetization requirements were back then, but I do remember that at the end of June of 2017, I had 500 subscribers. And in September of 2017, because I went to a mastermind or an intensive kind of situation with Tim Smoyer in September of 2017, so I can kind of remember, you know, what was what. In September, I had 1,700 subscribers. So my growth from June to September was about 1,200 subscribers. And somewhere in early July, I got monetized. So I don't think that there was that same, I know there wasn't the same 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch time hours that there is now back then, but I can't remember for the life of me what the requirement was, but I hit it around July 1st of 2017. So let's look and see how much I made in that first year of being monetized. Now, remember, I had very few subscribers. I had very little strategy, and I was just kind of getting my footing with who I was and what my YouTube channel was going to do. So I'm gonna go into my YouTube analytics and just choose the dates from when I got monetized to a year later. So let's do 7/1 of 2018. Now I'm gonna hit apply. So in that first year that I was monetized, I made about $4,600 in the entire year. You can see here on this chart that I made 9 cents the first day I was monetized. And I really didn't start making, you know, more than a few dollars a day until about January of that next year. So then it started climbing and climbing and climbing and climbing. So now let's look at the second year that I was monetized. So from July 18 to July of 19. So in that second year, I made almost $15,000 from YouTube. And again, very little subscribers. I didn't have a ton of subscribers even then. Obviously I was growing, but I made, you know, $14,000, $15,000 from July of 2018 to July of 2019. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do July of 2019 to July of 2020, but then I'm gonna show you current date for the last 365 days. I'm gonna also show you the year to date to today when I'm recording this, which is August 14th. So this July 19 through July 20 will be about 14 days different than what the actual year has been when I'm recording this. I'm gonna show you both of them. So this gets into what I've actually made in the last year from YouTube. So let's go custom again, and we're gonna do July of 19 to July of 20. So again, this is my third year of being monetized. Third full year of being monetized. And in that third year, I made $31,224.52 in a full year. That's insane. So before I show you what I have actually made year to date, so the last 365 days, rather than July to July, I wanna talk about something. So I know I've told y'all before, but I quit my corporate job when my oldest son was born, which this year is 10 years ago. And in that job, it was my first full-time corporate job out of college, and I stayed there for 3 years. So I was there for 3 years before I quit. And before I quit, I received a performance review, and I was going to be getting my like last step raise from the company like the month after I quit, or maybe 2 months after I quit. So for whatever reason, that marker and me being able to remember having that conversation, I remember what I made per hour when I left the company. And I made about $15 an hour. So if you do the math on what that looks like, I was making $15 an hour, 40 hours a week, which means that the last year I was there, if I was making $15 all year, which I don't think I was, I made $31,200 at my corporate job with a 4-year degree being the only income I was making. From July 1st of 2019 to July 1st of 2020, just my YouTube revenue was the same amount of money. Just from YouTube monetization. Not counting my courses I sold, my launches I had, my digital products I sold, my affiliate income, any of that stuff. And I think that's the number I saw when I was like, whoa, this is insane. It's insane. I mean, I was in a good job here and I was getting paid good money for someone who had a bachelor's degree, and I was making the same amount of money when I left that job that I now have made in a year's time just from YouTube revenue. That's literally insane to me. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and do year to date. So I'm gonna do the last 365 days here, and you'll see that that bumped it up about $1,500 or so. So in the last 365 days on YouTube, I have made $32,846.20. And you'll see here, as I've talked about before, my income really started climbing in March of 2020. So I can only imagine what that's going to look like in a year from now, because now I'm making even more money over the course of the next year. And as insane as it is for me to look at this and be like, oh my gosh, I made more money in the last 365 days just from YouTube than I made in a year at my corporate job, that's crazy. But to know that, you know, looking forward, that's going to possibly be double what I made in my corporate job, or that's possibly going to be triple what I made in my corporate job. It's insane to me. And it's one of those things that makes me just like super appreciative for the grit, I guess, that I had to say bye-bye to a job that I hated and to kind of branch out on this entrepreneurial journey. And it took me 6 years into starting my business, or starting businesses, to actually start my YouTube channel. And it took me a solid few years of being on YouTube before I really made any money from it. But I'm so thankful for it now. Like, so very thankful. And I think sometimes a lot of people who do these videos are showing you, you know, their overnight success. They had a video just take off in, you know, 2 months ago, and now they're making $10,000 a month from YouTube, or seven or eight or whatever. And my channel has always grown very consistently. I've never really had something that just completely skyrocketed my channel. Now, I will say my digital planner videos, when I released those in, I think the first one was in December of 2018. Those definitely grew my channel quicker than anything else I've ever released or had ever released at that point. I don't think they're the most subscriber growing videos now. But I just want to show you that, yes, sometimes people blow up and see major success on YouTube and have this like massive growth. And I pray that all of you watching this have that happen if you want to grow on YouTube, because it's amazing and it's awesome and it's cool to watch. But just know that going the slow and steady is going to get you there as well. Now, I would definitely be frustrated if I hadn't grown as much as I have grown on the platform, because it can be really frustrating to know I started this puppy in 2016 and I see people who come into my niche who just come in guns blazing and take off and hit numbers that I've not seen yet when they are brand new. And that, yes, that absolutely can be frustrating. But numbers like this, to see that I am making more money consistently from YouTube per month and per year than I did in my corporate job, make me realize that this is awesome. And whether or not I skyrocketed to success or I had the slow and steady growth that I did doesn't matter, because what matters is that this is a really great piece of revenue for me, and this is something that, you know, I'm so glad I started. So I know when I was just starting out, and even still to this day, I enjoy watching these videos where people talk about how much money they make from YouTube. And I know that every single month I share my analytics with you and I share with you how much money I made that month. But it's always interesting to look at it on a larger scale and say, how much did you make in your first year you were monetized? How much did you make in your second year, in your third year? And how much have you made in the last year? And I hope that was really helpful. I hope that was something that inspired you in some way, or, you know, showed you that not everybody just takes off immediately on YouTube, that sometimes the growth is slow and steady and that you will get there one day. You just gotta keep being consistent and you've just got to keep going. Now, I would love to hear what other YouTube specific tips you guys want to hear from me on this channel. So go ahead and comment below and let me know if there's something, just a burning question you want to know, if there's something that I can help you with, if there's a video that you are dying to see from me that I have not done yet, let me know in the comments below. And until next time, make sure you hit subscribe so you don't miss any other tips, tricks, and tools coming from your girl Jessica every single week. Bye, y'all.